At the end of the day, I'm a black man with dreads. So if I wear certain clothes, if I wear all black and I'm a black man with dreads and I go to a club, I've been denied before. So if I'm with a girl who is of a darker complexion and she gets denied at that club, I don't even want to be at that establishment. And when at one point I used to want to get into there, find a way, argue, debate, whatever, get in, pay top dollar, get in just to prove a point. But now at this point, I realize that is making me lose twice. And what I'm not going to do is I'm not going to let an establishment disrespect me and the person I'm with, especially if it's my girl, and then go into that establishment and show off, oh, I can afford to be here, because that's only putting money in their pocket. And I don't care to do that. So me personally, the way I would handle if anybody, my girl, my team, wasn't allowed in an establishment because of our skin complexion, I'm not supporting that business. Recently, I went to a very, very nice restaurant in New Jersey. And the crazy thing is, I realized when you are wearing certain things, you can get away with certain things. I had a tracksuit on. I didn't even realize that this was a 5-star restaurant. And I walk in with a tracksuit. It's like a Monday or a Tuesday. And she says to me, she's like, hey, normally we don't allow any athletic wear. And as soon as I walked in, I kind of already knew that that was the case, especially me being me. But I had a lot of jewelry on that day. And she said, but for you, I'll make an exception. So realistically, like if I didn't have any jewelry on and I just looked like a black man with regular clothes, I would not have been allowed in that establishment. But I kind of had to prove myself, which kind of made me didn't even want to eat there to begin with. You feel what I'm saying? So I don't like to support any businesses of that nature because it's very, very racist and it's very, very real. Like Holiday was saying, like I've been to Miami probably at least 100 times in the last 4 years. And I'd have been in every club, top to bottom, from the most expensive to the least expensive. One time, and this is the time that I was talking about, when I went to live, they would not let me in. They would not let me in. And I even had a section VIP reserved, whatever. And they still wouldn't let me in. They charged me $2,000 extra dollars on top of what I was initially supposed to get it because of the people I was with. And this shit is real. But for me, nowadays, I'm older. I don't even support. I was like, you won't let me in? Cool. We're going to go somewhere else. I'm not even wanted here. I'm not going to give you my money.
Yeah, but I feel like that's the ugly truth that they don't tell you about clubs. You know what I'm saying? Everybody want to go party, but like there's a lot of colorism and racism behind clubs. I've been to top clubs where they're like, you're not getting in because you're dark skin, or you're not getting in because you brought two dark skin girls with you. You know what I'm saying? Like it's a real thing. When you go to these clubs, you think you're going to have fun. And it's kind of like there's something about them rejecting you that make you want to go in there even more. Because everybody want to feel wanted. Like, remind you, you got your hair done, your nails done, your makeup done. And you can't get inside this club because you're too dark or you're dark skin or you don't fit there. You know, you're not white enough. That shit fuck with your mind. So now as a human being, you want to get in because why the fuck they're letting them in? And I can't get in and I look good. You know what I'm saying? I don't got no confidence issue. So it's kind of like, you got to understand, behind this club, there's a lot of racism. That's just what it is. You know what I'm saying? It's hard to get inside. If you're a dark-skinned girl, 95%, when you try and get to these clubs where you might ring into top celebrities, A-lister, they're not going to let anybody in. And they have a certain amount of black people they want to get inside these clubs. You know what I'm saying? Okay, we already got 5 black girls inside. That's enough. You know what I'm saying? One promoter told me, why you got 2 black girls with you? When I invite you, it's only you. You know what I'm saying? And when we got cool, he told me, Danny, I'm not racist. I love my black woman, but I got to pay my rent. When the club owner said they want a certain look and they want a certain like skin color, you got to bring that or you don't get paid. The promoters is not even being racist because it's black men that's denying these black women. But it's not because of them. It's because they're trying to get paid. They got kids at home. You know what I'm saying? If I'm on a date and I realize I'm the issue, that's the reason he can't get into a certain club or lounges because I'm a dark woman. You got what I'm saying? Or I'm a dark-skinned woman. I would want him to just be like, let's go somewhere else. You get what I'm saying? But I've been in a situation where I couldn't get in and the guy went in and be like, yo, I'm gonna hit you. You get what I'm saying? I've been there where the guy went inside and be like, you know, I'm going to hit you. You get what I'm saying? And it was fucked up. That fuck with my mind. As a woman, not being able to even get inside made me feel less beautiful as a person. Why can I get inside this club when I'm dressed up in club wear and my hair is in, my makeup is done? That really fuck with my self-esteem as a black woman. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not the only black woman that done went out one night and they can't get in. And they don't know why they can't get in. You know what I'm saying? And it's until I met people, because, you know, I became more popular and they told me, Danny, you could come. But when you come, you know, probably you should bring your white friend or your Spanish friends. You know, it's easier for us to get in because you know how the door works. After a while, when you party a lot, if you're a party girl in New York City, you know how the club works. You know who to bring or who not to bring. You know what to wear. Like, if I'm going to certain clubs in New York, I'm not going to wear a dress that make my butt look too big. I'm sorry. Like, I'm being totally honest. I'm going to wear something that make me look slim. I'm going to wear higher heels so I could look taller, so I could look like I'm a model of a 5'8". And it's really that in New York City and all major cities, like, the door is the worst. The door will destroy your self-esteem. I had to go look out in the mirror and be like, bitch, you that bitch. Like, they done did me dirty, but after a while, when I realized it wasn't me, it's the people I'm bringing around. Or I feel like I dimmed myself down by going to this club after a while because I had to change. I like having a big butt, but when I go to these clubs, I make sure my butt looked a little round, but not too much. You know what I'm saying? I like, you know, like, certain things I would like, I won't wear a dress that's too, I know what they, I learned what they like. And I started dressing like them and looking like them. But he had to learn. He told you he paid it at first. But then when he understood, like, if you don't want my people in, why the fuck I even want to be here? I had to understand that too. But, you know, when you're trying to be an entertainer, there's a lot of racism and colorism in it. So you're going to deal with it. Because I was thinking that's just part of trying to be a comedian, or that's just part of trying to be on TV. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's discrimination everywhere. That's what I was thinking. But you don't gotta be like that.
As any security or any guy at the door, yeah, I should just be more honest. You know what I'm saying? Because there's been times that I got denied, let's just say because I had sneakers on, but I don't watch five white men walk in right before me with sneakers on. I had Balenciagas on and he had Air Force Ones, but it was all right for them. Like, my sneakers cost 7 to 8 times more than his sneakers, but my sneakers are not allowed. So what I'm going to say is club establishments, doormen, be honest, and just tell them what it is. There'll be a lot less problems, and there'll be a lot more respected. And then I promise you, me, Danny, and people like us, we won't even argue with you. We'll rather just leave.